Hi, my name is Danielle, and I work here at the Cambrian College Teaching and Learning Innovation Hub. Today, I will help you both plan for an effective infographic, as well as create your infographic in PowerPoint. Phase 1, plan for an effective infographic. To begin, there are different styles of infographics. For example, you may want to dispel the 5 myths on a certain topic, or display the top 5 benefits of a certain concept or feature. You can also use your infographic to tell a story. Here are some points that will help you effectively draft out your infographic. First, consider the goals of your infographic. The possible goals of your infographic may be to generally inform, to influence new ways of thinking, or to influence new ways of acting. What are the facts? For example, here is an infographic I created based on the environmental benefits of going car-free. It is very effective to think about who your audience is. In this example, I would like to persuade my audience, which is students, that it is better environmentally to take the transit, to walk, or to ride a bike instead of driving a personal vehicle. To do this, I did some research based on typical student modes of transportation, and I placed that at the beginning of the infographic to effectively visualize the story I am telling. 3. Review the goals of your infographic and provide facts to inform your audience. First, research facts on the topic that will better tell your story or approach, and next, lay out these facts as if you are telling a persuasive story. For example, I am trying to convince students to actively change their modes of transportation. Therefore, I will begin with the effects of driving a car by providing facts on climate change. While you are paraphrasing your research, ensure that you consider which pieces of information would benefit from a visual, such as an image or an icon. I will delve deeper into finding icons in PowerPoint later on during this video. As well, remember that numerical statistics can act as visual points of interest, and there are also ways to include different styles of graphs in your PowerPoint infographic. 4. Include more persuasive facts that clarify your message. Again, ensure to revolve your facts around your ultimate goal. For example, I am again trying to persuade students to go car-free. So I provided facts on the general environmental benefits of going car-free, and by understanding that my target is students for this infographic, I did some research on the financial and general benefits of the lifestyle that I am endorsing. For example, a student would be able to attend many more events and luxuries if they used alternate modes of transportation. 5. Research. Ultimately, research is one of the key aspects of effective infographic design. My art teacher once taught me that a drawing is ineffective without a good outline, and I believe the same applies to infographics. Phase 2, create your infographic in PowerPoint. To begin, adjust the size of your infographic. Now that you have created an excellent outline, here is a step-by-step guide to help you create an infographic in PowerPoint. To begin, click Design at the top, and then click on Slide Size to adjust the size of your infographic. Click on Page Setup, and then select Ledger Paper for an 11 by 17 size. Most infographics are 11 by 17 to allow enough space for your visual story. As well, ensure that the infographic is vertical facing. Next, pick a color theme by clicking Design, then select the downwards arrow and choose a theme that you feel fits your topic. Another great resource for choosing colors is a website called coolers.co, which allows you to sort through color themes by theme, mood, or style. You can easily customize your colors by clicking Customize Colors here. Next, select a font that is legible and clear. A great, easy-to-read modern font choice could be Helvetica or Open Sans. Next, select a color for the background. A good choice is to use white or black for greater legibility and accessibility. However, if you choose to use a color, ensure that there is enough contrast between your fonts and the background. For example, red text on a green background would be an inaccessible choice. A safe choice is black text on a white background or white text on a black background. To set the background, click Design, then Background Styles, Fill, then Solid Fill. Again, click Design, then Background Styles, Fill, then Solid Fill. Select your chosen color. Next, ensure that your title is very large at the top. A good rule of thumb is 24 point for good legibility. Include your name and/or sources at the bottom. To do so, select the text box here and input your name and/or sources at the bottom. Next, refer back to your outline and create a grid structure of your content. Try to align your content as if there are invisible rulers on your page and allow enough spacing between pieces of information, such as titles and key points. Next, input your written text into the sections that you have allotted for each piece and input any images by clicking Insert, then clicking Pictures/Online Pictures. You can also input icons which are effective visuals for especially infographics by clicking here. You can easily search for icons by applying keywords in the search box. Finally, to finalize your infographic, review all of your content, spelling and grammar, and the overall format. It is also a good decision to review your infographic formatting by letting someone read it through to ensure that it is well designed and consequently well understood. To end, save your infographic as an Adobe PDF or a JPEG file. There you have it. You have completed the stages of creating an effective infographic. Thank you very much for watching today.